Now that we understand what's possible with animated vectors, let's walk through an example of implementing them. We'll return to this tick to cross animation we looked at and implement it. The first step is to create two vector drawables, one for the tick and one for the cross. Here are my drawables. I'm generating the path using my favorite drawing graphics package and then exporting the SVG and grabbing the path data from it. Soon, Android Studio will be able to import SVG directly as a vector drawable. A pro tip that I found helpful is to create a resources file to keep all of the attributes of an animation together. Here I'm calling it tick cross. For example, we'll need to reference the path data from a couple of different places. So saving it as a string resource and then referencing it makes this easy. Next, we create animators for each of the steps that are changing. Here's an example that morphs the ticks across. See how it references the strings we specified in the resources as the from and to states. Finally, we create an animated vector drawable, which connects the image to the animator. For example, this animated vector drawable acts on the IC cross vector drawable. It targets one of the path sections by name, here the cross path, and then specifies an animator to run on it, here running the cross to tick animation we just looked at. Once we have all of the moving parts together, we can show the drawable in an image view and start the animation when appropriate, perhaps in response to an event like a click. You can find the full source code to this demo linked in the instructor's notes. Fun details like this are a great way to entertain your users and show some personality in your app.